السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. You all know when people read the Quran and they finish reading, in most of our country, most of the recording, when they finish, what do they say? They say صدق الله العظيم. They say what? صدق الله العظيم. Yeah. So what does it mean? What does it mean, صدق الله العظيم? The Quran, it doesn't mean the end. It's not like the movies, at the end. No, it's not that. The Quran either tell us something happened in the past that nobody have seen. It is buried history, only archaeologists and specialists, they will find out in thousands of years. So when Allah tells us what happened in the past, we say, that must be the truth. Sadaqa al-Azim means, come from Allah, this is the truth. If Allah talks about the future, Abu Lahab, Abu, you know, his wife, the Roman Empire, this and that, future, unknown. Allah will say it will happen, we say, if Allah says it, it must be the truth. Sadaqa al-Azim. Allah talks about the Day of Judgment, what will happen in it? We don't know. If Allah is telling us, صدق الله العظيم. Allah is telling us the truth. The Quran is telling us the truth. But today I just want to take the first word. What is the first word? صدقة. صدقة means the truth. What does that mean? We give صدقة. Are we giving the truth? Yes. The صدقة, when you give, it means your faith is true. You believe in the truth. You're following the truth. When you give صدقة, it's a confirmation. The Prophet ﷺ said another word, he says, As-sadaqa burhan. Sadaqa is burhan. Burhan means proof of your iman. Because everybody work hard to earn the money. They love it. This is natural. It's not haram to love money. Yeah? Allah says, وَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمَّا. Human being, they just will die for the money. Yeah? They will absolutely die. Yeah? They give their life. All of us give our life every day. Every 3 days, we give a day for the money. Every 3 days, we give a day for the landlord, the owner of the business. Yeah. Every 8 hours, add them up, 24 hours gone for what? For the salary, for the deal he gives you. After 50 years, you've given big chunk of your life for the money you earn. So when you give that money you earn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it means you love Allah more than yourself. It means sadaqah, it means your iman, inshallah, is true. Because you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the whole purpose of our existence, is to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the believers believe what the Quran says. And the Quran says, أَتُوهُمْ مِنْ مَالِ اللَّهِ الَّذِي أَتَاكُمْ. When you give, you 100% believe that this belongs to Allah anyway. Allah give me the $100. He gave me $100 and He said to me, you enjoy 98.5%. Or 97.5%. 97, make me right, correct math. Yeah? 97.5% for you. And give 2.5% to the poor and needy. Don't give it to the sheikh. You go and find the poor and needy and give it to them. But guess what? Some Muslims don't do it. I'm a Muslim, I'm a good Muslim, and they still say to Allah, no, I need the 100%. I love the 100%. And they don't give zakah. Zakah is the foundation of Islam. It's actually foundation of Islam. If, you know, it's like any other foundation. You deny it, you don't do it, you should doubt, is the person complete Islam or not? And there is two ways to calculate the zakah. Zakah is haqqullah fil mal. It's the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We owe it to Allah. You owe it to Allah. It's not like you're optional. It's you owe it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is two ways to calculate it. Either by the value at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, they didn't have cash, they didn't have the notes. They had gold or silver. Yeah, they had gold or silver. So you can calculate it with gold and see the value, or silver and do the value. Gold is 85 gram of gold. So if the gram of gold today, just hypothetical, $50, then it's about $4,000. That is, if you have $4,000 in your account, since the last year, you owe Allah 2.5%. From every 1,000, you give $25 out. You owe Allah $25 from every 1,000. But some other scholar said, nowadays, majority of the ummah, the billion Muslim, don't have that $4,000. Then not many people will give zakah. And it will disappear. This will, you know, the idea of zakah, the kids don't see it because they don't have $4,000. If you translate that in our country, you buy a house with $4,000. Then there's another way, and this, subhanAllah, is the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the beauty of the deen. In silver, silver is very cheap. Silver, a gram is 70 cents in this country. And how many grams to carry, you know, to do it? Is 595 grams. If you have that value in your account since the last year, you must pay the 2.5%. You guess how much is that? $435. If you have a saving with $435 in your account since the last Ramadan, you owe Allah the 2.5%, the $25 in a 1,000, which is, if you have only $500, is $12.50. It is very simple, but it's sadaqah. You prove your iman that you are calculating it, you are aware of it, you mark it in the calendar. It's like any bill. You know, with our bills, the wife will knock your shoulders. In 2 days, the bill is due. Have you transferred the money to the account? Have you said, yeah? But this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's account. So you must mark it in the calendar. And the scholars say, you must name the day. You say, this is the day I'm going to pay zakah. You mark it, and especially in Ramadan, because everybody's in the mood. So in Ramadan, you say, I will pay my zakah every year in the last 10 days of Ramadan, I'll mark it, the 27th, for example. And you put it in the calendar, and you remind her that this is the day for zakah. How you do it then? You look at the account. To be generous, to be really generous, you look at the account on the 27th and pay zakah on that account. Even if the money is going in and out, and it has not been there for a whole year. Allah knows, only was there 2,000. You're supposed to pay zakah for 2,000, but now you have 4,000 in account. What's the difference? You're going to pay $50 more? It's for you anyway. Yeah. So they say, those who earn salary, like most of us, just keep it in an account, don't worry about calculating it every month. Every year, that day you set for yourself, you owe Allah the zakah. And it has to be lunar calendar month to calculate. Don't calculate it in the other Gregorian calendar. It has to be because it's a Islamic ruling. It has to be in any of the months that we know, Ramadan, Sha'ban, any of this month. But Ramadan, of course, is the best because Sadaqat Ramadan and the Hasanah in Ramadan, the good deed in Ramadan, is absolutely, absolutely more than any other time of the year. Yeah. So just a reminder, it's a pillar of Islam, and the value is actually very low. We don't know that. We think rich people pay zakah. No, no, no. All of us are rich compared to most of our African brothers and Asian brothers. Yeah, $400 for them, some of them will never see it in their lifetime. Yeah, some of our people will never see $400. They're sitting in the street, millions of them, waiting for a truck to come to say, labor, somebody to dig some garden, somebody to carry some wood. And that's all they do. They jump on the truck, they go to the factory or the farm, wherever it is, and at the end of the day, they get that few dollars. And that's all they have all their life. Every day, just a few dollars. So $400 for them is a dream. For us, you can't even shop in the supermarket with $400. Yeah? If you say to the wife, restriction, only $400 in the supermarket, you will be with your mom. She will send you home. Yeah? So honestly, sadaqah is from the heart. It is the proof that you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why Umar ibn al-Khattab saying, Al-A'mal tatabaha yawm al-qiyamah. The good deed will be shining in the day of judgment. Yeah, the good deed, salah and zakah and hajj and sadaqah and fasting and all this. And you see, a sadaqah will be the most proud. Because it's giving. It's giving money. It's not like, some people can pray tahajjud every day. 20 rak'ah, 30 rak'ah, is it 8 or 22? And no problem. But the minute the books come in front of them, they will be looking for the coins. Where is the coin to get this box away from me? Or pretending to be talking, pretending to be checking the phone. They can read the whole Quran cover to cover, mashallah. But yeah, giving, it's like taking part of their skin. Yeah, so we need to be generous. The Prophet ﷺ was the most generous. So, subhanallah, you look at his seerah, most generous. But in Ramadan, he'll be more generous. How can he be more generous? I just tell you, he taught his family. Subhanallah, his family became like this. Aisha used to fast like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, the fasting normal, every day. And they had, you know, family member and stuff. Aisha got more than 400,000 dirham, a gift one day from one of the great Sahabi. 400,000, you can buy a city. The servant in the house, she said Aisha was fasting. At Maghrib time, they didn't have money to buy something to break the fast on. And she said, Mother of the believers, we don't have anything to break our fast. Did he save any? She said, he didn't remind me. Why didn't he remind me? I forgot that we don't have anything in the house. Just giving. Abdullah ibn Umar, his annual benefit was 43,000. And they say the day he received the benefit, the 43,000 for the year, he will be buying on credit from the shop. He doesn't go to his house. They just don't like it. They don't want this pile of money they're responsible for. They just know this orphan and this widow and this people and that side. And then they will rely, subhanAllah, rely on the income or the daily work, whatever it is. So this is the generosity of the Sahaba. Why? Because they trust is what is with Allah is more what's in my pocket. What is with Allah, more barakah than what I have in my bank account, wallahi. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know the hadith, yeah, they had the whole lamb in the house. In the morning he did the halal, Bismillah, Allahu Akbar, left the family to prepare the whole lamb. When he comes home, he asked Aisha, he says, how much is left from the lamb? She said, it's all gone. ذهبت كلها. I've given it all away to all the poor and needy and the neighbors as a gift. Only a little bit of the shoulder. Here it is. I just struck the, you know, half a kg. Here it is. Just enough for your plate. The Prophet reversed the sentence. He says, بقيت كلها. It's all remained for us. This is what gone. You know, she says, it's all gone. Except this. He says, no. It's all remained. We've given it to Allah. It's remained for us forever. This is what is gone, what he eat. The Prophet ﷺ said, the human being will keep saying, Mali, Mali, yeah? My bank account, my house, my business, my family, my clothes. The Prophet ﷺ said, no. Fix it. What is yours is what you ate and consumed, not what's in the fridge, in the bank account, because you can die and all the bank account to somebody else. They will put their hand in your pocket, take the wallet and take the credit card. They won't bury it with you. If you have a fancy mobile in your pocket, they're not going to leave it with you. They're going to take it. Your loved one, if you have a gold teeth, they will take it. The Prophet ﷺ said, don't say mine. Yours is what you eat and consume and burn out, or what you wear and wore out. It has to be thrown in rubbish, or what you give in sadaqah. تَصَدَّقْتَ فَأَبْقَيْتَ. What you invest for akhra eternally is what you get. That's yours. Name that, what you put in the box, my money. That becomes yours immediately. But if you still have it, nobody guarantees it's yours. It's the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us generous and kind. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase our blessing in our earning. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase our prosperity in this life and hereafter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our sadaqah, accept our generosity, accept our fasting. Allahumma taqabbal siyamana. Allahumma taqabbal siyamana. Allahumma taqabbal siyamana. Allahumma taqabbal qiyamana. Allahumma taqabbal du'a'ana ya rabbil alameen. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وجزاكم الله خيرا.